Another run started, and we are on the play. This end is good since we have all the colors and we have 3 lands. As before, I prefer playing a top land on turn 1 than playing the Ghost Fireblade. Because if I draw a 2 drop, I can play it. Okay, a 3 land is like the best start in this format. Ernest can generate a very good draw. See, Dragon's Congener is very good with the flyers, and we have the Sun Step Outcast to enable it. Okay, so it is with 3 colors, with 4 colors, sorry. We go ahead with the Sun Step Outcast, and hope to draw one on top lane after Dragon's Congener next turn. It's better to play like the Morph and then a Keep. Yeah, probably it is. Because we rely as well on drawing lands. You know, probably with Temur Charge, I could play like the Sage Area more. And then like, we didn't hit the bottom. So if we play the Sage Area the turn before, now we can equip and play this. But if we draw land, yeah, Dragonskin General would be good as well, unless he has like a Morph and we trade. So well, what I do here is like to play the Sage Harrier of Kites face down and bash it both. Quite unfortunate that he has Master of the Unseen, which is like one of the best cards in the format. But we have a very good rare too, we have Gossard Blade and Dragon Scale General, so this will be a tough game. Okay, he show us like for land. I kinda wanna keep the morph and attack with these two. And play another morph. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I wanna face Whisk Away now. At the end. Okay. And I'm gonna more Flesh's Doctor. Dreads is a good card because it lets him play a threat and Master of the Sea. So now what I'm gonna do is like attack with the Sand Step Outcast and the Spirit, because then I can bolster. I'm gonna bolster the Spirit, but maybe it doesn't. This Sand Step Outcast is not doing anything in the ear. So I'm just happy to trade with his mana, probably. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if this is true, but if he just take 2 damage, I would bolster from 1 additional. So it would be good as well. Next turn, I can flip the Sage Eye or the Sage Eye area. And bolster for 2. So Tide Scavenger. Have to draw some lands to play this card. But we did not. Yeah, I'm fine with morphing these and attack. We just did. And keep getting the Spirit bigger. Not a good turn, that's for sure. But we don't have a whole lot to do. We could have played a Whisper of the Wood and hope to run on top lane to play Shifting Loyalties, but. There's 7 lands here. I also kinda wanna destroy this more so that I can bolster the spirit again. Nah, that's not a smart play to do. Also, I don't wanna play shifting trade the spirits here. Yes, I'm okay with attacking with these two. I like destroy my morph to get these to 4. Then Whisper of the Wilds will give me 2 mana so that I can play Shifting Loyalties. This is very card disadvantage. But I'm in the plan all in flyers since like on the ground I can never pass with Master of the Unseen. So I'm just going for this. I don't know if you wanna block with the Sutes Convention of the Moor. This is not a very clear block. Might as well take. Oh, that's even better. No, my plan don't work because I'm so bad at this game. Yeah, of course, if I bolster on the spirit, if I play Whisperer of the Element, oh, what's the name? This don't bolster. So well, I'm just gonna pass the turn. Oh. Yeah. Just gonna pass the turn and bolster on the spirit. Okay, then this work, and then the spirit can attack, finally. Yeah, completely, but in the end it worked well because okay, so you keep like doing nothing. Not that we are doing a lot as well. I'll attack with these two. Putting mantras doesn't make a lot of sense, so I'm just gonna play this Whisperhood Elemental. Whisperhood of the Wild, sorry, not Elemental. And yeah, and then Shifting Loyalties it. This Desk Avenger. Keep attacking with flyers. It's gonna go on the All in Master of the same plan, which is fine because. Just letting him live, but if my Shifting Loyalties plan works, I will get to attack for 8 next turn. And my life is very high, so, you know. If now we attack, so I can't block. Oh, that is fine. Can't block for sure, since it fights. I did a good draw here. I'm just gonna attack with the flyers again. I hope it didn't manifest any flyers to block mine. Just take 5, okay. And then play our Surveyor. And I think I'm gonna bounce the scavenger. It's more. And then outlast the Surveyor. So this dragon skill elemental is doing some work. first skill, what's the name? I keep forgetting the name. That was the general. Yeah. You keep on manifesting. Probably you didn't find any creature, but I doubt this. Manifest again. Well, this is a 4/4 flyer now. No, sorry, 5/5 flyer. Yeah. Good card, Dragon Sky General. Yes. Gaining 5. He has 7, 8, 9, 10 lands. So can't double manifest and play Scavenger. That's important. But you can like attack, kill one of these cards, and then play Scavenger and double manifest. But I think you can't double manifest because you need to flip something to gain life. I can also. Shifting Loyalties is flyer. If he's gonna play it. And see, this game is very interesting. Scavenger is fine. And he has now 7 lands. And, just pass. Well, Ruthless Instinct. That's a good draw. So now I can play Shifting Loyalties or just attack with everybody. If he's gonna gain 6, he goes to 16. He takes 10. Yeah, he never dies if he flips. But if he flips, I mean, there shouldn't be anything under those manifests since the term, maybe just this one. Just this one could be a flyer. But other than that, I think Shifting Loyalties, the flyer with like my Whisperer, probably. Yeah, I can't play Temur Charger and Shifting Loyalties, of course, since I don't have land. Here, and the point is that the Scavenger doesn't do anything in this board, it just chum block. So I don't care about the Scavenger and attack with my creatures. With those, yeah. Okay, so this is just a 2-2. We know it didn't trigger and double block. And I can play Reckless Instincts. Yes, and that's what happened. Say okay. And then what I want to do? Do I want to play any creature post-combat? Yeah, I'm gonna play Mandroids post-combat. I'm gonna tap this for two. If this works, we are in very good shape. Seems to work. First away will be the worst card you can have. Remyropex. That's a good flip by him. Yeah. He's gonna gain like infinite life. Oh, sorry, already gained infinite life. And then gonna delve my. The point is that. What does these wooden mandrills in this world? Just a 4/4 with the death touch guy in the back, a lot of manifest cards. Maybe I wanna keep cards in the graveyard for a treasure cruise. And just play like a thermal charger face down. Because the fly effect could be reasonable. Even though this mandrill blocks. Yeah, that's what these mandrills do. These mandrills block. Yeah, I don't think I have time to play treasure cruise in this game. And also this Dragon Scale General now is like gigantic. to 6-7. Never attack because he's tied for reds. He has tied for reds. So funny that I have 4 lands and can play all these spells. I'm at 15 and we'll keep gaining life, but we're all dealing him 10 damage each turn. He needs to find it. Okay, so this Soul Flyer is flying. He can now just manifest one time. The point is that now I'm fine trading Soul Flyer with Spirit, or I want to take control of it and giving him my Whisper Elemental. Sorry, Ardaida. So this Whisper of the Wilds. I think I want to take the Soul Flyer here. Since with like 4 mana, then I can play Temu Charger and flip if I draw. Yeah. I'm fine doing this. Yes. And then attack with all the flyers. He has 4 cards in the hand though. Also, if I trade the draw card, which is like value, then I can pump my spirit better than pumping the Soul Flyer. Let's see what happens, because if he takes 10, he goes to 5, he shouldn't have any creature under those manifests. He has to manifest again. Or 3 discard. I think now I'm gonna put tokens on Soul Flyer, because he can have bounce spell. And the point is that bouncing is Soul Flyer is worse, because it doesn't have I the only thing I care are flying creatures. Yeah. And he doesn't have any creature in his graveyard that is flying, that flies. So I don't care if he bounces back the Soul Flyer, then well I care if he bounces my spirit token, because I won't have it anymore. Now what? Playing a dragon, which is fine. I need to draw a green card now to flip the Temu Charger and win for sure, even though I'm very likely to win this game no matter what. Instead we drew a land after like a lot of time. And well, we just attack with all the flyers and play another flyer. He can manifest here because of Whisper Root Elemental. He has 2 mana. He should do it now because this dice doesn't have more. Smite the monsters. Well, can't do anything. He's still dead. Let's see. A Ruthless Reaper, oh my god, he morphed those two. So fun. Okay, so it's not dead yet. Sorry. Okay, so now we play our Lotus Path Gene and poster onto it. Is still needing an answer to our flyer. That'll gain him 6 lives. Let's see. Oh my god. This is so bad. Play, well, I'm gonna lose this game unless he loses for time. I'm gonna play that. I'd rather play this and like put the counter on it. Now probably I probably should play the Lotus Pachin. Oh no, I bounce. I bounce the token. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I bounce the token. And then bolster on it. We just bolster one. Get 8 cards in this library. Manifest. And yes. Okay. So I attack with my flyers. Take 4. Now play this guy. And I don't want to play Temple Charger since Dragon Skill General will pump it. I'm just gonna pump like. He's manifesting his whole deck, he's searching for something very, very powerful for sure. There's 2 cards in his library. He needs to have a good card there. I'm just gonna attack with everybody. Bam. So here, how do I block? I'll block the Grim Arrows packs. I like some random manifest cards. Like this is land. Sorry, what is this? This is land. I like this one. Yeah, and take the rest. I'm probably gonna block the 2/4. Well, unfortunately, Treasure Cruise just say draw 3 cards, not forced to draw 3 cards. That would be funny. I'm gonna morph something. I didn't do the math. I'm likely to lose after. Yeah, it turned the point where he played like a blocker and just made the monsters and survived that turn. And then the supplement form also make him survive. Yeah, Master of the Sin just won the game. Let's see what he has. Okay, that was game. So basically see his old deck and he has like Sandblast and Supplant 4 and stuff like that. He has a bunch of flyer, but most important as the enchantments of Return to the Arrow. I got the main deck. What I don't want here. I don't like shifting loyalties. It wasn't good in the game I played. I just got on this.